But some people do. Some corporations, they do both. They have a profit and a no profit. Yeah, right.
African American corporations.
Right, they do both.
That's the way the wealth. That's the way the wealthy exist.
Right.
They have a corporation that creates so much wealth that they have to give back.
Right.
They don't struggle with a nonprofit. Why would you struggle with a nonprofit entity? So that's why Rage will never be a nonprofit. We will never be a 501c3. We use our
Wait.
Yeah, never.
Wait. You're not a 501c3.
No, you're not a 501c3.
You can't pimp the people without being a 501c3.
Right,
you got to learn how to pimp.
We have chosen and are standing by that. We will not be a 501c3.
Wow.
There's too many things that we might want to do that. We may want to run our own alderman. We may want to do some lobbying.
Right.
So we don't want to get into the game of the 500 other organizations here as a 501c3.
Okay, I got to be careful in public access.
Yeah.
How do you get money?
We work.
Okay, cool.
So most of us work.
Most of it come out your pocket.
It comes out our pocket.
Like when this camera shut down, you will hit me for some money. Say, where's it at, Mar? I know you got it.
Yeah. So you know, it's not about that. And our passion. We just did a student club, right, at Wentworth Elementary, and I just commended our work group, our education and youth development work group. We did a great program from January through May, absolutely no funding. The children went on field trips to Columbia College. They made their own songs. They created their own video. They cleaned up Inglewood community. They learned public speaking. They had a session on bullying. We did all of this with absolutely no budget and no funding.
That means Wentworth Elementary School has a very good principal.
She does. She's a great principal.
I'm gonna go meet her.
But at the same token, we was an organ. It's about 10 other organizations.
Okay.
Who say they can't do anything unless they have funding within that school. Whereas we came in as Rage and we didn't have any grants or anything at our table, and we have connection with these students. These students texting me now, looking for stuff to do on Sundays to get back into the community.
Well, you know, most of these schools, the pillars of the community, as you well know, is the school and the church. School and the church.
Right.
Then you have the businesses. School, church, business.
That's true.
Versus family. Let me start again. Family, school, church, business, whatever. But the principals, I mean, let's face it, most black people who make a little money, whether they school teachers and principals, they walking on eggshells.
Right.
Because everybody, I mean, they can get rid of us at any turn.
True.
So they're afraid to lead in the way they should lead, where they know that downtown or somebody may.
Right.
And once you lose that good job, it's over for us.
Yeah, well, I think, you know, it's so many schools here, and there's some innovative principals that are here in Inglewood.
It is.
Who are willing to take that risk and willing to do everything they can for their students in their class. Maybe they might not measure up on the test scores or whatever the case may be, but the culture of the school is positive. The students are positive. I mean, we have a great relationship with Wentworth, and we're building relationships with other schools within Inglewood. So we see a lot of the positive that just a lot of folks don't see because they're staring at the test scores. So.
Yeah, but see, they need to do some videos like this.
Oh yeah, we just did a video for them.
You got to send it to me.
I know, I do. We just got it.
Oh, like, you just got okay.
Just had an Umbrage member who used to do video production. Who
there
went
you go.
To school at Wentworth.
Not just Mammy Mae stuff. I do real stuff.
He went to school.
I'm Mammy
Mae. At Wentworth, he's alumni for Wentworth.
Wow.
And came in and did the video for them.
Wow.
So again, you know, we are able to leverage assets and identify assets through the community, and so we don't come in Inglewood focus on the needs, like the 500 organizations that come through. We are focused on the assets here. It's so many assets in Inglewood that we could turn around this. If we all work together, the assets in the community, we could transform this.
But see, when you poor, and most of us who even watching this show are poor, most of us two, three paychecks away from poverty, we'd be hating on folks in Inglewood, but we just barely above them.
I mean, some people are very, very poor in Inglewood. They're below the poverty rate of about $15,000. But it's about 30% of us who are not, middle class, who live in the
community. Live in Inglewood.
Yeah.
What I'm saying, that's what I'm trying to get at. There's human capital. When you're poor, you don't understand human capital. Like, say, Mark, give me some money. No, you don't need any money.
Yeah.
You need human capital.
Right. And the people who are, you know, the underclass that are here, they are human capital. They have assets that they could contribute.
Right.
Completely.
Right.
They can help clean up the vacant lots.
Right.
You know, that's human. I mean, we could transform it in a way. And we're working with so many different groups now because, you know, Rage can't do it alone. So we're working with other groups who have that same type of mindset. Like, how can we really transform this community in a really effective way? So I have my hand in education and youth and other things, but also in just beautification in general. Like, what could we do to get out and just clean up the corridors within Inglewood?
You know how I feel about that. If we just clean up the curbs on the streets, that would be a huge difference.
If we just did that a couple of Saturdays ago. We had Greater Inglewood Unity Day. Over 20 organizations came out, 100 volunteers, elementary school students, high school students, college students. We had a great time in the couple last week.
Let me close out the conversation, Aisha Butler, by talking about a sense of hope. People, I don't care if you, you know, whether you make 50 grand, 150 grand, or 10 grand a year. People need hope.
Yeah.
They need a sense of hope that things are going to get better.
It will, and I'm telling them that it will. As long as I'm here, I'm in the game for at least 30, 40 more years. So I will be very old and gray by the time, you know, I'm done.
But there's people like me have seen folks like you come and gone, and yeah, things ain't got better.
I always say I have mortgages here, and I'm.
But how do you give people a sense of hope? They say, Ms. Butler, I ain't got no money. I ain't got no education.
But you have a gift within you that you can share, that you can give back. You have a gift. Everyone has something in them that is unique that they can give back. It might be, you might be able to talk to people about your story. Maybe you did go to jail. That is a story that people, young folks here need to hear. Maybe you was a teen mom. You may need to talk to other teen moms about some of the decisions that you made. I mean, it's not all about money. It's really looking within and saying, you know what do I have that I can share? It is so much need here in Inglewood. We would never meet the demand.
But how do you
never meet this?
But I'm assuming that, you know, and I've been through it. We all have pity parties where you feel, I don't have any value.
Yes,
I don't have any education. I don't have any. How do you tell that young mother, the young man who's an ex-offender, the young sister's ex-offender?
Right.
I have value.
Yeah, you live it. That's why, because you're still living, you're still here today, and you still have a story to be told, and you do have value, and you just need to just really hone into what is that value. If you went to jail and you're a felony, maybe your value is sharing your story with others and showing how people can deter from that type of lifestyle. If you are a young, pregnant, you know, teenage mom, maybe you could deter 5 other teenagers who thinking about or contemplating having sex at this point. So I think everyone has value. I mean, that is the biggest.
Are you saying Aisha Butler, that our self-worth shouldn't be tied to our net worth?
No, it should not be. And actually, if you do it that way, most likely your value is low. I definitely don't tie my set worth to my net worth at all.
Give people your phone number.
Oh, definitely contact Rage at any time at 866-845-1032. You can speak to me.
Say that again real slow so I can put it on the screen.
866-845-1032. You can contact me. I'm the president of Rage or any of our other Rage members through that number.
And you go on the internet, people, this video
Rage
is worldwide.
RageInglewood.org. You can Google us. We have a Facebook. You can go on my blog, missinglewood.blogspot.com. We have so many different ways that you can connect with us.
You know,
excuse. Even if you don't have the internet, just pick up the phone and call us.
I was hopeless. I given up all hope. And I do give up hope at times. Yeah. Then I meet Aisha Butler.
Oh.
I'm serious. And I say, there is hope.
Yeah.
And I think that's what people have to feel. There is hope. And I do have value.
Yeah, you do have value, and it's definitely hope. We could do this. We just have to be very strategic and organized. And we just need to build our human capital, just like you said earlier. That is what's going to turn this around. Not a whole bunch of cops, not a whole bunch of different ideas that's coming from the outside. It's going to be the folks on the inside joining together to rebuild our neighborhood. Rebuild, rebrand it, and revitalizing the whole entire neighborhood.
I'm going to go home because I don't like to be out in the hood when the folks come out. See, it's Sunday morning.
It's quiet and it's peaceful.
Yeah, I know. In the morning. But I ain't come here in the afternoon and night.
In the afternoon, it's still quiet and peaceful.
You know what I'm saying. I know. We got to love our people, don't we?
Yeah, we do.
All right.
I love my life.
Okay.